Hello, my name's Professor Tom MacDonald. I'm the director of Memo Research, which is a university organization. I'm a consultant physician and I'm also a professor. And our unit was asked to carry out a study comparing the relative cardiovascular safety of two medicines for gout. One of them was an older medicine called allopurinol, and the other was a newer medicine called febuxostat. Now, when I say comparative safety, what I mean is that heart attack, strokes, and vascular death occur in the real world. But are they any more common or less common with either drug? So we recruited over 6,000 patients with gout who were already taking allopurinol. And these patients were then randomized to continue their allopurinol or take febuxostat. So randomization is a process where, by the play of chance, patients have a similar chance of getting either option. We then followed these patients up for quite a long time, an average of 3 years, but some patients were in it for a lot longer than that. And we counted the heart attacks and strokes and vascular deaths that occurred in each group. And what we discovered, which was there was no difference in heart attacks, strokes, and deaths, vascular deaths, with either drug. Now, that's what's called a composite endpoint. In other words, you could either have a stroke or a heart attack or a vascular death. And when we dug down further into that data, there was no difference in vascular deaths between the two groups. And this was really important because there was some worry that febuxostat might be associated with vascular death. But in fact, our study exonerated febuxostat to a large extent. And we think that might be for the benefit of patients. The reason is that febuxostat is a good deal easier to use than allopurinol, in that one dose lowers your serum urate level, which is the thing that causes the gout, very significantly. Whereas allopurinol needs to be gradually increased, and it has some side effects when it's introduced. So the FAST study was important from a regulatory perspective. It, I think, helps clinicians treat patients, especially those who cannot take allopurinol, as it provides a very viable option for them to use an alternative medicine. Now, the implications for family doctors and other GPs are that we can now reassure patients that either medication can be used. In fact, it's probably easier to use febuxostat. There are some regulatory implications of this. Febuxostat and allopurinol have slightly different regulatory ways of being used. And at the moment, febuxostat has a warning about these drugs being used in patients with cardiovascular disease. We found no evidence that there was any problem in cardiovascular disease. And so we think that that warning should probably be withdrawn, but that is a matter for the regulatory authorities. So we'd like to thank everybody who took part in this research. I think it was very important from the point of view of doctors and patients who suffer from gout. And gout is the most common inflammatory arthritis in men that there is. And so this does affect a lot of people worldwide. So thank you for your help. It's been great. And we'd like to keep tabs with you if we can, if you're a patient, because there is a long-term follow-up that we would like to perhaps engage you with maybe in 4 or 5 years' time. Okay, thanks very much and goodbye.